Yes, sir.
Thanks, Terry. That's better.
Over there, don't stay over there so long.
Okay.
If I'm talking.
Okay.
And be judicious, kind of like me putting salt on food.
Yeah.
About your sins.
Exactly.
Your sins. Don't get carried.
Not going to do it much.
Don't do more. If anything, do it less.
Less is more.
Less is more.
Marshall, this is interesting. We're 10 minutes early and there's already 15 people watching.
Sounds like what?
Everybody's got one of those square plastic things.
Oh, an egg carton?
Yeah, this is your MTV behind the scenes special. I can't believe we got people watching and we're still 10 minutes from tip off, but I'll play some of Marshall's music for you while we're waiting. Reaching into the back catalog.
Hearing it?
Yep.
This is gonna pop. I love it. What time is it?
2:49. Marshall, you want a sip of coffee before you start your
beer?
We're getting requests already.
What?
Michael Phillips from Spartanburg, South Carolina wants Mississippi Man in Mexico.
That's Jim Horn.
Mm-hmm.
Played with Steve Winwood. Played with Jim Horn.
Katie Janke's on. Hey, Katie Janke.
That looks a lot neater, doesn't it? Man, they call him Dagger Dan.
Real good care of me.
It's like Eyebrow Steve.
Yeah. Hey, Tina. Glad you're here.
Can they hear you? That means they can hear me.
That's right. Well, Tina said hello, Chris. I think
hey,
I
should... Tina. Oh, I'm gonna sing that.
I know. That's why I'm not doing it.
I'm gonna sing that.
I'm not playing anything you're gonna sing, Marshall. They're getting it now. Trying to give y'all a little taste of some of the old Marshall songs that need a band.
Thank you, Terry.
Thank you, Terry. Finish this and do that. Yeah.
Well,
I think, Marshall, I was thinking no because you don't have your Martin guitar here. We'll do it at your house.
Marshall, which album is that one about?
I said yes.
What album is that song about? Somebody chopping your cable, the cord to your cable TV.
I think it's a documentary.
$2.55. Marshall. 5 minutes.
Yeah,
they don't need to hear that.
Yeah,
no. This is a true story, y'all.
Inspired by Joe Sal. Yet another stuff.
mc@tallgirl.com is the PayPal name. Thanks for asking, Dan. Sadie Jackson wants to know if the song called Little Buddha is about Jamie.
Yeah. Yes.
Yes, Sadie, the answer is yes. The name of the song is Call the Llamas.
I wrote it when he was dying.
But Marshall wrote that when Jamie was passing. Dan McLean, you are getting a new song tonight. All right, Marshall. $2.59.
Oh, God. Wait, let me get you.
Well, I'm gonna give them one more old one while we're waiting. Got it, Tina. I want to see it. Steve Shaw, your top fan in Hollywood, California, wants to hear Road Hard and Put Up With. Yep. Here's the old version. Let him hear a guitar riff, Marshall. You don't like rote work? All right, well, you're on. And I'm off.
How's everybody doing?
Everybody.
I'm Marshall Chapman, and we are gathered today on this July 4th, 2020, Year of Our Lord. I'm down here with Chris Fletcher and the empty. Chris, can you show them this place? Give them a scan.
Well, here you go, folks. This
here we go.
This is.
We are at
Springwater.
Springwater Supper Club and Lounge.
And here's what makes it a supper club. Right there. That little vending machine that spits out potato chips.
Yeah, that makes it a supper club.
and that's the bar.
There's my Pabst Blue Ribbon sign.
And now we're going. And now we're going back to Marshall.
All right.
I'm trying not to mess this up, Marshall.
This is one of Nashville's oldest. It is the oldest bar in the state of Tennessee, and it's been empty since about March 23rd. They closed the doors because of the coronavirus. So we've been coming in here playing just about every Saturday, except every now and then Chris and I take off to go to the beach. And we're going to be, we'll be broadcasting from here, live streaming, from here a week from today. And then 2 weeks from today, we're going to be back at Pawleys Island, but we'll be in Georgetown, South Carolina at the old Rice Museum. A friend of mine's having an art show there. Check it out. Her name is Esther Sharp. And if you Google her, she's got a website that shows some of her paintings. They're beautiful. Does like portraits, these sort of Andy Warhol kind of Jackson Pollock portraits of people. She really captures their souls. Anyway, Steve Shaw, I'm gonna start with a song you wanted to hear. It's the first song I ever wrote. Good place to start.
He also wants a new song.
Huh?
He also wants a new song.
I'm gonna do the new song, but I can't do them all at the same time. I have to do one and do another. It wouldn't sound good if I played them all at the same time. All right, y'all ready? Here we go. First song I ever wrote, I was living about three blocks from here. We'd all been to see John Prine for the first time. And I just heard songs like Hello in There, Angel from Montgomery, Sam Stone. And I thought I'd died and gone to heaven. And I was an aspiring songwriter. I kind of started scribbling songs, but I hadn't really finished one. And so we went back to the front porch, and my next door neighbor was a guy named Bubba, and he disappeared. And then came back, reappeared, with a mason jar full of moonshine. And being a polite Southern belle, I thought, well, I should partake, just to be sociable. Well, that was at night, about 1, 2 in the morning. And the next thing I know, it was noon, and I was face down in my front yard, which was a vegetable garden, wearing nothing but my underpants, all right? Crawled back up on the porch, really hungover. And this old Martin guitar was sitting there, and I started playing this kind of up-tempo Chuck Berry kind of lick, and wrote my first song, Steve Shaw requested it. Steve Shaw lives out there in Hollywood, California. Thanks for tuning in, Steve. This is for you and anybody else that's ever been rode hard and put up with. Well, I feel like I've been rode hard and put up with. Lord knows last night was a night that I will never forget. I can't remember what happened, but it must have been the best one yet. Cause I feel like I've been rode hard, put up with. Oh, oh. Honky tonkin' in Nashville all night long. I heard John Prine, Chris and Wet, they were smoking a song. Oh God, there was a Johnny Rodriguez, David Allen Coe, whoa, whoa. It was a swarm herd of songbirds doing time of music, whoa, yes it was. Now I feel like I've been rode hard, put up with Chris. Lord knows last night was a night that I will never forget. I can't remember what happened, but it must have been the best one yet. Chapman and the Red Tinsel Boys.
Perfect.
Take it, boys. Later on that night, I had to fight my way back home. Then safe and sound, I heard the ringing of the telephone. Any sense at all, and I'd have left that damn thing alone, y'all. God, I got a frog in my throat. But a fool loves company even more as the night moves on. Yes, we do. And then what happened?
Well?
And then I went next door wearing nothing but my underwear. There was Matthew, Ellie, and Josh. Yep, the game was all bad. But Bubba had a jug of moonshine from Greenville, South Carolina. Well, I thought I was dead, but they said I sang one last line. Help me, Chris. Here we go. Two, three. Y'all sing this part.
Nothing could be finer than to be in Carolina in the morning.
Alright, that's rode hard to put up with.
Marshall, we gotta give a shout out to Carol Goldman, who's the only one that said she raised her hand when you wanted to know if anybody had ever been rode hard and put up with. Carol said, I raised my hand.
Well, you know, it's a funny expression. I used to hear my dad say that all the time, and all it means is you kind of, you know, if you grew up around horses, you know, when you've ridden them hard, you're not supposed to put them in the stall wet. You got to walk them to cool them down or they'll get sick, you know. And so it's really just an expression that means you're tired. But honey, when I recorded that and it was on my first album for CBS, there were press people from the New York press flying into Nashville to interview me, thinking it was some sexual perversion thing, like a song, you know, some women's lib song that she'd been rode hard and put up wet. In other words, you know, the guy got satisfied, but she didn't, so to speak. I could say that in different words, but that's about as nice as I could say it. Y'all get my drift? I mean, they were reading all kind of things. I said, sex. I said, hell, it's just about being tired and kind of hungover. You know, forget this unfulfilled expectations of women. Oh, my God. They were just reading way too much in it. But that's back when the press in New York City, besides living in a fast-living city, they were probably high on the amphetamines and thinking way too much, all right? This is a great... great song for the times. I've got to tell you, I've been racking my brain, hoping to find a way out. I've had enough of this continual rain. Changes are coming, no doubt. It's been a too long time with no peace of mind. And I'm ready for the times to get it better. Too long time with no peace of mind. And I'm ready for the times to get it better. Seem to want from me what I cannot give. I feel so lonesome sometimes. I have a dream that I wish I could live, and it's burning holes in my mind. It's been up too long time with no peace of mind. I'm ready for the times to get better. Too long time with no peace of mind. I'm ready for the times to get better. All right, let's all hum it together now. Here in Nashville, Tennessee. He went on to produce Garth Brooks and a lot of other people. He's a great guy, a good friend of mine, and a great songwriter. Thank you, Alan. This is my favorite song of yours. It's always good to have a song in the minor key. I'm going to do a song that I have not. This is our 15th. 5, 10, 15. Our 15th. Chris?
Yeah.
It's our 15th live stream today.
Congratulations.
By the way, yesterday was a real important day to me. Yesterday, I know Chris is raising his hands and covering his ears.
He's covering my eyes and ears.
He's covering his eyes and his ears. Y'all, yesterday was the 50th anniversary of me losing my virginity. Y'all got that? And you're not going to believe how old I was. 21! My mother was such a bad... I mean, my mother, she was... adamant about, you know, you didn't have sex with somebody unless you were married to them. Well, I wasn't planning to get married to anybody. I was married to music. But still, it made an impression on me. So here I was, 21. My older sister got married to this guy from New York City, and I was a bridesmaid in her wedding, and so was my sister Dorothy. Well, that was in June 7th, 1970 was my older sister's first wedding. And so Dorothy and I were both bridesmaids. Well, by the end of the summer, Dorothy and I had both lost our virginity to two of the groomsmen in the wedding. And the groomsman that I went with was up in New York City. He was 49 years old. I figured he knew what he was doing. And you know what? I was right. And my younger sister, she ran off with a guy that was 28 from Easley, South Carolina, and divorced. And I think that upset Daddy more than the fact that he was divorced, which they started going together, than the fact that I was dating a guy 49 years old. Anyway, that was the summer that Daddy started going to therapy. All right, that's all I'm going to say about that, y'all.
Thank goodness.
Maybe you can send in some Facebook messages about your first experience, if it's anything you care to share, anything interesting. But mine was in New York City on 61st Avenue. Is that what you call it?
61st Street.
61st Street between York and First. That's where you live. York Avenue and First Avenue. Can't remember the name of that apartment building. I used to know it. But it's right there near the Queensboro Bridge. That's all I'm going to say. Chris Sayer. Come on, Marshall. Sing a song. I'm going to sing a song I hadn't done in any of these 15 live streams. It's based on a dream I had. I saw this young couple hitchhiking to Memphis, Tennessee, going down I-40. And they were carrying a guitar. He got a rhinestone jacket from Porter Wagon's van. She wearing high heel sneakers and a hold in his hand. They're doing the duck walk to Memphis in the full moonlight. They're gonna check into the Peabody Hotel for the night. They're rockabilly sweethearts, syncopated love, rockabilly sweethearts. They got every single record in the Sun catalog. Yeah. He got his hair piled up in a pompadour. She got them long legs moving out across that floor. They got no bags, just an old guitar. Stratocaster got them where they are. They're rockabilly sweethearts, syncopated love, rockabilly sweethearts. They got every single record in that Sun catalog. Yeah. Third verse. They take the elevator ride to the 13th floor. They got lucky there once and now they're looking for more. The windows and the curtains open in their room. They're gonna sing their song to the cat in the moon. They're sweethearts, they got every single record in that Sun catalog. Yeah. Booby dooby, goodness gracious, great balls of fire. Booby dooby, they're gonna check into that Peabody Hotel for the night.
Marshall, I just want to say three things. Number one, we have broken the record for the most viewers on any of your live streams today.
You're kidding. I figured everybody would be out on the boat.
Well, they're not. They're here listening to your stories. And Kelson Slayman wants to know, regarding your earlier question, if there's a plaque commemorating that event.
There should be, Kelson.
And
I'll tell you, if I had a daughter, I'd want her to have the same experience I had. Because, you know, I went to Vanderbilt. I was the last one in my age group in school, in high school, and in college to lose their virginity. You know, I was too busy hanging out with Jack Clement and just, all I cared about was music, you know? It was just like, well, what's the big deal? Also, you know, that was back when they'd make us come in the dorm at night at Vanderbilt, and they separated boys and girls. So we had to be in. There was like a curfew, okay? And so when we get in, I'd hear all these stories from these girls that had just, they'd be crying. Some football player had squished them. They'd be bleeding. They hated it. They said, oh, it's awful. Don't do it. Don't do it. So I didn't. I figured I ain't going to do it with one of these Vanderbilt boys. They don't know anything. It's like those boys that Randy Newman wrote about at LSU. College boys at LSU, they go in dumb, come out dumb too. Yeah, well, that's the way the Vanderbilt boys were. So I found me an older man in New York. All right.
Well, I must just say, Marshall, there's one more person who's answered that question, and I believe that the statute of limitations has probably expired on the story he's related, and that's fortunate for everybody involved.
Woo! Man, this is getting off to a hot start. Happy 4th of July, everybody. We don't need fireworks, do we?
No, we're making them.
Lord have mercy. Lord have mercy. Heard that somebody out there wanted to hear, speaking of hot, Mississippi Man in Mexico. Yeah, I wrote that in heat. You know, most of these songs I wrote, I was in heat, like in my 20s and 30s. Hell, I was 62 when I wrote this song. Who wanted to hear Mississippi Man? Was that Steve Shaw, too? I hadn't done it in a while. That's all right, Chris.
I'm going to find it for you.
So you can scroll down?
Yeah, and go back through all of them.
Hey, Terry, are you hearing any of this?
I'm in conversation.
So where'd you lose your virginity? That's what we're discussing.
I'm still losing it.
Oh, you're still? Y'all get that? Can they hear it, Chris, while you're scrolling?
Yeah, they can hear you, but I'm not sure they can hear Terry.
Did y'all hear that? We're here with Terry Cantrell. I asked him when he lost his virginity. He said he's still losing it.
Michael,
I like that answer, and I'm gonna steal that and use that as my own.
Michael Phillips wants to hear Mississippi Man.
Michael Phillips, Spartanburg, South Carolina.
That's right.
Mississippi Man in Mexico. How'd you get down here? Must have been a long, winding road. Mississippi Man in Mexico, before you disappear. Wanna know all there is to know about you. Yeah, outside San Miguel, the fires were burning. That moon so bright, I thought I might go blind. You laid a feast before us at your table in a field of cactus grown by your own hand. Buenos noches, Mississippi Man. Woo! Mississippi Man. Woo!
if I may. Adios, ora ora. And the funny thing about this song is I wrote it on the 4th of June. That dinner that we were describing, that feast out there in the moonlight, was on the 4th of July, 2009.
Marshall, I didn't think it was possible to get a new type of request, but Susan Lifford has just requested to play a song for a baby that's still in utero and is due to be delivered on July 22nd. Busy, busy, busy.
So this is for a baby that's inside its mother's stomach?
Yes, has not been born yet.
Well, I can take a little bit of a song.
She wants busy, busy, busy. That's what she wants.
How about, hello in there. Is anybody home? That one about looking inside for my brain.
Oh, yeah.
It's dark as a dungeon.
Hello
in here.
Hello in there.
Hello in there. Is anybody home?
It's dark as a dungeon here.
I'm going to strike two sticks together. That's what it takes to start a new idea. There's some great lyrics in there about being in a dark, enclosed place, because I wrote it about my brain. It could apply to a baby in utero. Hello in there, is anybody home? Oh, hell.
Next week.
Next week, Susan. That baby will probably be out by then.
July 22nd.
When's it due? July 22nd? I bet that baby's having fun, because, you know, when they get to be this age. I got to tell you a story, though. One time I was driving through South Carolina. I was about 56 years old. I was on a book tour. And I was on my way to Atlanta to some literary event, and I called my mom. I was passing through Spartanburg, but I didn't have time. I was trying to make an event in Atlanta, so I called Mama. She said, where are you? And I said, well, I'm at the Skillet, right there on the corner of Pine Street and Main Street. Mama said, well, I'm right here a block away at the church. I'll meet you in the parking lot at Bobo's Funeral Home, which was right next door. It used to be in this old house right next door to the Skillet. So I pulled up in my, and there was Mama, and I got out of my car and got in her car, which is the car I'm driving now. And we just sat there in silence, a mother and a daughter. Susan, this is related to you, to what you just, your request. And at one point, I put my head in Mama's lap. I was just so tired. I'd been driving for weeks. You know, when you have a book out, all you do is drive to these events. And then nobody was saying anything. It was just a mother and a daughter having a moment. And then all of a sudden I said, Mama, you know what? The world, and this really applies now, the world is so scary. Sometimes I wish I could just crawl back up inside your uterus. I liked it in there. And Mama, y'all have to know my mother. She's a very practical woman. She kind of digested that in her brain for a minute. And then she said, you can't. You're too big. You wouldn't fit. Okay? Anyway, that's my story. I'm sorry, I got a frog. Had a frog in my throat ever since I died here. I'm going to try to wash it out with a little Guinness. Cheers, everybody.
Rick Bedarjan says hi.
Hey, Rick. Up there in Del Mar, New York. Well, this goes out to that baby and to
its mother.
You know, the thing about that baby, getting ready to be Susan and Eddie's grandchild. That baby doesn't know anything about what it means to hate, you know, or hate somebody because of the color of their skin. That baby is completely innocent. And I truly believe, even when I see on TV people yelling hateful things, things at each other because of the color of their skin or whatever. If they don't have the same religion or the same politics or something. It breaks my heart, really. Because I know deep inside that person is this child. It's all about love, okay? It doesn't matter. Oh, I need to raise this. It doesn't matter. What did it matter?
Where you're coming from.
It doesn't matter where you're coming from. It doesn't matter what damage was done. We're all on a journey. Our goal is the same. Gonna be happy like children again. So be your own parent and treat yourself good. It's never too late to have that happy childhood. That's right. I used to think freedom meant running away. Love was a feeling that never would stay. I searched this world over, but I never found a big enough shoulder to muffle the sound. So cry if you need to, it might do you good. It's never too late. Some never make it, some never try, some try to fake it, some barely get by. Survival is easy, it's that living that's hard. And it takes lots of courage just to be who you are. So do what you love, not what they say you should. It's never too late to have a happy childhood. That's right. Never too late. Yeah, yeah. All right, happy childhood. I wrote a new song 2 days ago, or I might say it wrote me. You know, Guy Clark wrote a song. I think he wrote it with Gary Nicholson. Sometimes you write the songs, and sometimes the songs write you. I love the ones that write you. Those are the songs that come out, and you can't stop them. They just demand to be written. And I wrote this song, and it's a strange little song, and it's probably was inspired by the current political landscape. And I've always been real careful about anything. Like, I wrote a song called Guns Are Us. And a lot of people thought it was anti-NRA. It wasn't anti-anything. It was just a statement of fact that guns are us. That our culture, America, everything about it has always been about, what's that amendment?
Second Amendment.
Second Amendment and freedom to bear arms and all that stuff. So I was just stating a fact. And then the verses talked about some things that had happened, like a friend of mine had gone in her kitchen and her four-year-old boy was on the counter playing with opening a brown paper sack that her husband had left, and it was a loaded pistol, and it just freaked her out. And then that was also Columbine had just happened, where the guy went in and shot all those people in that school. So guns were on my mind, but when I write a song, I want to get below whatever the political thing is and get to the truths that are universal. I hope that's making sense.
And you did in that song, Marshall.
I don't know if I did or not.
You did, because you said the problem the answer to the problem is you and me.
Oh, yeah.
That the problem is us. It's the guns Charles, are not the problem.
Bobby Charles has got a great song called The Solution to Pollution. And that's probably where I couldn't have written Guns or Us if he hadn't written that, because he says the solution is you and me.
Mm-hmm.
That's the solution. It's not the government legislating stuff. We've all got to just look within our hearts and change. And, of course, I say this almost every week, but I'm hoping we're going through a period of history that is unprecedented in that we not only are as close to a depression as we've been since the 1930s, the Great Depression, we're having a pandemic like 1918, and racial unrest like in the 60s, and it's all happening at the same time. And my great hope, you know, people tell me, I just want things to go back like they were. Well, guess what? Nothing's going back like it was. The only thing that's constant, that doesn't change, is change. Things are evolving all the time. And I'm just hoping, I know I'm looking deep in my heart, because I grew up white and privileged in the Jim Crow South, and I've just been looking really deep in my heart a lot lately. And there's a lot to look at. All of us. So this is a new song. I think I announced on Facebook that I was going to play it. And let me see if I can remember it, Chris. God.
I know you can.
Sorry, I've got this. I didn't sleep last night, so I tried to sleep this morning, and I got all this crud. Usually by, 3 o'clock, this stuff's had its time to work its way out of your throat, but when you slept as late as I did. What key did I do it in?
You wrote down the keys on something.
I can't remember it. I don't have my book. Do you have it on your thing?
I do.
Okay.
You want me to play a little of it?
Yeah, play a little bit of it, Chris. I'm having a senior moment, y'all, but I'm going to do this new song.
Ready?
Yeah, I think I've got it. I think I've got it.
Okay.
Yeah.
But I can give it to you if you want it.
I got it.
All right.
If I can just get this crud out of my throat. Y'all ready? New song. First time anybody's heard it. Besides Chris. It don't matter how smart you are, Chris. It don't matter how high your IQ. Once your brain has been washed, you're gone. I've got people I call my friends, and I love them with all my heart. But once they think God's on their side of politics, they're gone. MSNBC, Fox News, CNN, I'm sick of all of them. Yes, I miss Walter Cronkite, and yes, you may think
I'm old,
and yes, you may think that I'm old, but there's one thing that I know for sure. How smart you are. cute. Cause once your brain has been washed, you're gone. It's called Once Your Brain's Been Washed. Okay. It's a little bit different. All right, we got any requests out there, Chris?
Leaving Lochipoca.
Leaving, who wants to hear that? Oh, you don't know. Okay. It's Road Path. Well, before I do that, I'm going to do a song. I promised to do it, and I've been practicing it, trying to get through it without messing up. Because, you know, this brain... I don't know if mine's been washed, but it's been scrambled a lot. This goes out to Dale and Peach Hinch, who say that they are each other's perfect partner, and they wanted me to do my song, Perfect Partner. This song was fortunately recorded by Jimmy Buffett on his Last Mango in Paris album, and we actually wrote three other songs that were on that album, and then he recorded my Perfect Partner. Boy, I'm glad he did, because it changed my life. You know, when Jimmy records one of your songs, it's not like getting a country hit or something. I always say his fans breed in the off-season, and then they keep, it's the gift that keeps on giving. Let's put it that way. Anyway, I love this song. And I'll tell you, this is another song that was inspired by Joe South, who was my boyfriend from 1980 to 1983, but I met Joe and I was trying to get his attention. So I thought if I wrote a really good song, you know, trying to get his attention, that he would love me. I think that's the reason a lot of songwriters write songs, is they want somebody to love them. So anyway, I was trying to get Joe to love me. But Jimmy loved this song because he said it reminded him of the Drifters, a song that the Drifters or somebody like that would do. And it reminded him of summers at the beach, you know, in those pavilions, dancing, seeing a girl, wanting to dance with her, and wondering if she might be the one, you know.
Good. So here we go. It's a good 4th of July song.
Is it?
Yeah, because everybody's at the beach.
Oh, yeah. Over here, there's a girl. Never seen her before. Her eyes looking straight at you across a crowded dance floor. Ooh, she's smiling. What a beautiful sight. Oh, I got a funny feeling. She's gonna dance with you tonight. She could be the perfect partner. She can take it in her stride. She won't try to lead or follow. The perfect partner at your side. Chance. You gotta let somebody move you. Ooh, and it can happen at a dance. When there's that rhythm you can move to. Ooh, here she comes, boy. She's coming straight to you. She's gonna ask you if you wanna dance. Now what you gonna do? Cause she could be the perfect partner.
should step for third.
How will you know?
Marshall, we got 50 minutes, and somebody that's never requested a song before, and you might need to work this up for next week. He wants an oldie that I've never even heard you play called Going to Hell and Get It Back.
Oh, my God. That's a band song, but let me see. I wrote that song because I was mad, and it was inspired by Lynyrd Skynyrd. I worked with this producer, the same guy that produced Sweet Home Alabama. He produced my second album, a guy named Al Cooper. And Al self-admittedly was a little overbearing as far as being a producer. And so he made Lynyrd Skynyrd so mad, that's why they wrote Cry for the Bad Man. And so after I worked with him, this song squirted out. Because I listened to Cry for the Bad Man, and then right after I listened to it, this song came out.
Would the person who requested that please tell us where you're listening from? Thank you.
Oh, okay. All right, now let me look at my list. Oops. Last time, see if we're checking it off here. Dale and Peach Hanch, we did The Perfect Partner. Somebody wanted to hear Rockabilly Sweethearts, I did that. Oh, Dan McLean from Fredonia, Alabama. How you doing, Dan? Are you tuned in? He wanted to hear Betty's Being Bad.
He is tuned in.
And he wanted to hear the new song, too, so we checked that off. Betty's out being bad tonight. Betty and her boyfriend had a big fight. She found out what everybody knew. Too many cooks for the stew. She don't care what nobody thinks. She's gonna be bad till the whole town stinks. Betty's being bad. Betty's being bad. How bad? Bad, bad, bad. Oh, she's out being bad. Betty's out being bad tonight. You know, Betty and her boyfriend, they had the big fight. Yeah, now she went home when she found out. Said, pack your bags, I want you out. Her boyfriend thought she was talking jive to him. Saw her standing with a 45. 45's quicker, 409. Betty cleaned the house for the very last time. Betty's being bad. Betty's being bad. How bad? Bad, bad, bad. Whoa, she's out being bad. Betty's out being bad tonight. You know, Betty and her boyfriend had the big fight.
How you doing, Chris?
Now you go out and you see Betty. Don't scream and shout unless you are ready. You're ready to rock, ready to roll. The hill freezes over and you catch a cold. Betty's not mad, she's just getting even. Betty's being bad, it's her way of leaving. Betty's being bad. Betty's being bad. How bad? Bad, bad, bad. Oh, that's still bad, bad, bad. Betty's out being bad tonight. You know, Betty and her boyfriend, they had a big fight. Bye, bye, Betty, goodbye. Bye, 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 Betty, goodbye. Bye, 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 Betty. Bye, 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 Betty.
All right.
Going 90 miles an hour with a hair on fire. Running on a tank full of burning desire. She's heading out on highway number 29. She's leaving Lochapoca, Alabama behind. She's leaving Lochapoca. She got great big dreams. Bid for a small town. She got some songs in her head, they just a swirling all around. And now she's singing them out loud, and it feels so fine. She's leaving Lochapoca, Alabama. Yeah, hello Nashville.
as the sun goes down on all the little towns. And as the people and the houses began to settle down. Oh, there's a flash of life across a Tennessee state line. Oh, she's leaving Lochapoca, Alabama behind. Yeah, she's leaving album. But it's my first album of doing songs that I didn't write. I'm doing songs that have kept my soul alive these 71 years I've been on the planet. And it's got everything on there from Leonard Cohen, Bob Seger, Carole King,
J.J. Cale,
J.J. Cale,
Elvis, but not really Elvis.
Well,
Otis Blackwell.
Sammy Kahn and Jules Stein, an old jazz number that Frank Sinatra recorded called I Fall in Love. I fall in love too easily. I fall in love too fast. I fall in love too terribly. Love to everlast. What are you doing, Chris?
2 minutes.
My heart should be well schooled, 'cause I've been fooled in the past. But still I fall in love too easily. I fall in love. It's got that on it, and you can order it by going to my website. If you just scroll down, it's just right there. Order Marshall's new CD, and we don't have. Probably within a week, Chris, I think you'll be able to order my back catalog too. We don't have the old CDs out there, but we're gonna get that back up because we got a new website. But you can get the new CD. I know most of y'all have it, but I'm still trying to pay the cost of making this record. So if you have it and enjoy it, email a friend and tell them about it and send the link. Send them the link. Help spread the word. That would help me a lot. And because, you know, I feel like every Saturday I'm preaching. Y'all are my choir. And I know y'all have been so supportive. None more supportive than Susan Litford, who's my distributor down in Wadmalaw Island. She bought 11 CDs. All right, there's a story behind that. And also, we got a tip jar because Terry lets us come in here to Springwater, and I've still got a radio promoter I'm working with, and Chris is working with me. So if you, you know, like, want to leave a tip in the tip jar, you can go to PayPal and just give them my email address, which is mc@tallgirl.com. And any contributions, we really appreciate it. And I know my distributor down there in Wadmalaw Island, y'all been more than generous, so we appreciate it. You all have. Dale, you guys give something every week, and it goes, believe me, I notice it, and I appreciate it so much. And I love you guys.
What are you going to close it with, Mom?
He's got the whole world. This is my 4th of July closing. Wait a second. He's got the whole world in his hands. He's got the whole wide world in his hands. He's got the whole world in his hands. He got the whole world in his hands. He's got the you and me, brother, in his hands. He got in his hand, he's got you and me, brother. In his hand, he's got the whole world in his hand. He's got the little bitty babies, even the ones that haven't been born yet. In his hands, he's got the little bitty babies. In his hands, he's got the little bitty babies. In his hand, he's got the whole world in his hand. He's got the whole world. Really appreciate you guys tuning in every week. Thank you. I'm going to try to do my recitation since it's the 4th of July. I was thinking about my country when I recorded this. You can hear it on the CD. There's a part in there where it says, Lord, I worry about my country. And I'm talking about America, y'all. I want my country to be a beacon. Yeah, like it says in the Pledge of Allegiance. Liberty and justice for all, y'all. That's everybody. Ah, yeah. In his hands, he's got the whole world in his hands. He's got the whole world. Oh, God, I hope he does. In his hands, whole wide world. In his hands, he's got the whole world. God have mercy on us all. He's got the whole world in his hands. We'll see you next week. Thanks for tuning in.